Welcome to Telltale Games, Game of Thrones. It's taken super long to get this working in OBS. I don't know why. I literally don't know why. And I have a cat that definitely wants to destroy everything, and I think that my voice is starting to get sore. But we're going to go ahead and do this. Now, some of you might remember I did Telltale Borderlands. And that was incredible and amazing and awesome. And Riga kept me up for the last hour where I was definitely breaking. So let's do this. Alright, Cottontail, you made snacks. Welcome to the shit, friends. The Northerners will never forget. Begin episode 1. This game series adapts to the choices you make. The story is tailored by how you play. For thousands of years, House Forrester has been loyal bannermen to House Stark. In the darkest reaches of the Wolfswood, they harvest rare ironwood trees. Now the North has been ripped apart by war, and rival houses seek to claim Forrester Ironwood for themselves. And the fate of House Forrester hangs in the balance.
The trout in the towers, the wolf dropped the fish and they all ran away. The trout, he flossed off for hours.
Another ball of prey.
Two weddings brought on by the headings, the knife he cooks for me. Two weddings brought on by the headings, and all the
ton of white men with beards, yo.
The great Jamie Lannister. Kingslayer, Oathbreaker, brought to his knees by the men of the North.
And set free by the women. You'd think he'd done it himself the way he tells it. Lord Forrester's sword won't clean itself, you know.
Morning, Death Demon. Alright, it's time to pick up Lord Forrester's sword.
Make
sure
it's squire this time. Lord Forrester won't be happy with blood and brains all over it. Go on. It's only blood.
Well, his graphics quality isn't great.
It's a proper sword.
I'll have one like it myself someday.
You'll never have a sword like that. And I say that as a friend. And if we're being honest, you are just a squire.
Oh, don't be an ass, Bowen.
Apologies, your lordship.
I had a hand in it, you know.
A hand in what?
Capturing him.
He was nowhere near the Kingslayer at the Whispering Wood. He was so drunk, he barely made it out of his tent. Next, he'll tell us he caught Tyrion, too.
Shh. Let him finish.
Yeah, dick.
He'll talk
Shut
all
the hell
night
up.
If you let him.
Good.
You captured the Kingslayer.
Aye. Well, I had a hand in it.
Aye. A hand round his ankle as 10 others took him down.
See? What do I tell you?
I brought him to his knees.
Lord Forrester.
Not before he dragged you halfway across the battlefield on your face!
You're questioning Norrin's honor.
I'm questioning Norrin's story, which grows more far-fetched every time he tells it.
Get your liege lord some wine.
Go on. It's your job.
I don't take orders from you.
No, but you take orders from him. You idiot, you're his squire. I'll fetch him some wine.
You dick, man. Bowen, you're an absolute piece of garbage.
Thank you, Garrett. I'll do it. Norrin's family has faithfully served House Forrester for centuries. His honor is beyond reproach, and House Tully is forever in his debt. They've never seen a field plowed so well as the day the Kingslayer dragged poor Norrin across the battlefield.
This is a cool dude. He serves all this.
The night we celebrate.
Serves his own squire, huh? Alright. But this is Game of Thrones, so of course he's got some huge
names. Rob Stark!
On.
The King in the North!
The King of the North!
Tomorrow, we march on Casterly Rock, and House Forrester has been given the greatest honor to lead the Young Wolf's army and ride as the vanguard!
gods have favored us.
No, they have not.
Onward
nope.
To Casterly Mm-mm. Rock!
Listen, I've read all the books.
Lannisters!
Winter is coming.
Let's hope it waits till this bloody war's over.
Got it.
I read the first five books, and I saw the first season of the show.
I need you.
I know how this ends, dog.
For Roderick.
As his father, I could not be more proud of the man he's become. On a night like this, men find false courage at the bottom of their cups. I'd rather he were here.
Yes, my lord.
Is also the question, what's to be done with you?
Make me a knight.
It's been on my mind for a while now. Something must be done.
With me, my lord?
You've served House Forrester well for several years now, but I can't expect you to squire forever.
Be nice to be a knight, my lord.
How shall I reward your loyalty? What can I offer you? You served me well.
To bring honor to House Forrester, my lord.
You have more honor than those who were born to it. There were those who had their doubts when your uncle put forth your name as my squire. But you've erased those doubts entirely. It would be an honor to see you riding by Roderick's side in the vanguard tomorrow. Not as a squire, but as the equal of any man who serves House Forrester. It's well deserved, Garrett.
Thank you, my lord. I promise. I won't let you down.
That I don't doubt. But for now, keep this between us. We're celebrating tonight. I wouldn't want the other squires to feel discouraged.
Yes, my lord.
Now go and find Roderick if you can.
I will, my lord. Thank you.
So everyone's gonna die, and then no one will ever know I was made a knight right there.
Squire! Fetch us more wine!
Can you give me a hand? Come on. Make it up to you. Yeah, no problem.
I have been a squire longer than you.
So?
I outrank you. You should help me.
I said I would help you, you fucking dick. Cripes.
Fetch more wine, scrub my armor, clean my boots. Just my luck to end up with Norin while you serve the Lord.
Are you serious right now?
Fetch his own wine for once. He's a drunk, a liar, and an arrogant prick.
You'd better watch your tongue, Bowen. It could be much worse.
What the fuck do you know about it? Nothing is worse than Norin. See, that's where you're lucky. Low expectations. If I'd grown up covered in pig shit, shovel and slop, well, maybe I'd think saddling his horse was the greatest honor in the Seven Kingdoms.
Thank you for the host, Riggs.
This beats pig farming. But not by much.
Who doesn't love bacon?
Ah, pig farmers. All I'm saying is, at this rate, we'll never be more than this, which is nothing. The lowest of the low. For all I know, we could be squires for life. All in wine around a fucking wedding.
Give it time. You'll get there.
You'll get there.
Easy for you to say. Maybe if my uncle were castellan at House Forrester, I'd feel different.
Who my uncle is has nothing to do with it. How much further?
It's right over there.
Oh, fuck. Really? During the Red Wedding? Are you joking with me? Are you jo- My voice is dying.
Take your time.
You lot have drunk your share. Good thing Lord Walder's in a generous mood.
Fucking phrase.
Nice night for a wedding.
Well, armed with swords,
huh?
Finds
a willing husband for one of his daughters.
I mean, if you haven't heard what the Red Wedding is, you're about to be in for a surprise, friends.
Don't expect me to carry it for you, Sir Garrett.
Actually, I am Sir Garrett,
What's
asshole.
Wrong?
Haha!
Run into you. You're acting rather odd.
We need to get back. Now.
They're fine, they can wait.
No, you don't understand. We need to go.
Oh my god.
Take the fucking flagon already.
Are they actually playing the song?
What's wrong with him? Something the matter?
Bowen, we have to go.
You go if you're in such a rush.
And so it
We have
goes.
To warn the others.
And so
good luck.
Wow, Bowen literally just got stabbed through the neck. Well, he was kind of a dick anyway. Yeah, I chose to leave Bowen. I served my noble lord as a knight. Fuck these people. Dude, this Roderick is fucking baller. All hail Robb Stark, King of the North! No! Not that guy.
Ready, boys! Whoa! Shoot that one!
Got my sweet shield! Get wrecked! Foresters for life!
What?
Oh, I fucked that up really bad. Wow, did I just get shot in the eye? Whoops. I gotta tell you guys, this mouse movement is super weird. Like, they've definitely fucked with the timing. Try to do better. Getting shot in the eye is definitely not what I'm trying to do here. Foresters for life,
ready,
buddy.
Boys. Whoa! Shoot that one!
And so it. And so it.
What?
Lord of Castamere. Now the rains we pour them on. Whoa, shit! That seems bad. Probably shouldn't run towards it. Yeah, combat roll under it like a boss. Fuck these dudes. I'm gonna wreck it. Oh no! Man, this is brutal. I remember Telltale Games, Tales from the Borderlands just like talk to people for the first hour. Right? There's literally none of this balderdash. I'm getting murdered! Ah! No! I don't want to die! Do a sit-up real quick. Get this dude stuck down here. Yeah! Suck it! The North remembers, bitch. Why would you do that? I mean... You have to have seen plays before, right?
Good fucking riddance.
You have to know that if you call out someone's name during a sword fight, they're gonna turn around and get stabbed in the back.
Garrett, did you find Roderick?
He's dead, my lord.
Speak up, Garrett.
The Freys. They slaughtered him, my lord.
Where's my squire? You didn't leave him, did you?
What happened to him? Speak up, boy.
I had to leave him. I had no other choice.
Find a weapon, quickly!
Use the force, Garrett. Use the weapon. Really? You just smile at each other like a bu- Have you guys never seen
you
a fucking...
Go, my lord.
I know they don't
time.
Have television, but they have to have seen a play before. They have to know they're doing all of the wrong things. I know they have entertainment in a Game of Thrones. People ride fucking pigs into combat.
Seven hells.
We have to keep moving, my lord.
I'd never make it. Hunt us down like dogs.
Walder Frey says time to fight.
We've got to go, my lord.
guard this with your life. Return it to Ironwrath, where it belongs.
I knew I'd get
There's
this
no
sword.
Time to waste.
See, at the beginning of the game, I said I'd get the fucking sword.
The hands of those traitors.
What the Frey said,
you have to go.
I will do as you command, my lord.
You have served me well. I know I can count on you.
The North remembers me.
Tell
lord.
Your uncle. Tell him. The North Grove must never be lost. Tell no one but him. Do you understand? You must swear. Tell only your uncle Duncan.
I
the future
swear
of the house may depend on it.
I swear that I will, my lord.
Hey, it's those foresters.
Now go. On your honor, you must do this for your house. Go!
Kill those fucking foresters!
And see, it's reasons like these that most D&D characters should have more than one weapon.
We love them, the Frey!
Because when you lose your main one, you're basically boned. Oh, they're doing the thing! Wow, it actually looks pretty cool. In this, like, animated version instead of, like, the claymation stop version. The twins! The Wall. Jon Snow. The North remembers Jon Snow. You know nothing. I'm guessing Ironwrath is the stronghold of House Forrester. The SNL skit, South Westeros, is actually really good. Where they have Jamie Lannister show up and do some gangster-ass shit. Why would I be traveling on the King's Road? That's literally insane. I'm carrying a sword worth more than my life. Covered in blood. Wearing no armor. But a leather tunic. And there's a fucking pig. My father was a pig farmer, I guess. Maybe. I can walk around and talk to pigs. Hello, pig.
Lord. Fresh.
It's warm. I have a sword icon over here. Oh, there must be something. Give me a sec. I can see that my mouse is going crazy. Might explain why I'm sucking all night. Well, I guess it hasn't been all night. It's literally been like 10 minutes. 15 minutes. 15. I can't believe we're only 15 minutes in. You want to talk about a messed up internet connection, by the way. Uploading another 11 hours of videos yesterday, 11 hours the day before that. And I'll be uploading 12 by the end of this day if we do the entire stream all together. YouTube is not liking my shit right now.
That's Father's car.
Tales from the Borderlands was comedic and funny. This is dark, man. Dude's like, "Hey, where are you going?" And I'm like, "I'm not gonna save you."
Give us fucking titles for this.
Ah, of course, Bolton.
Be coming, but at least still have his bacon.
Let me guess, you killed my whole family. Oh no, the Boltons and the Hangmans. Of course they betrayed the North.
Move along, boy. There's nothing for you here.
Father.
I said move on. Unless you want to get fed to the fucking pigs.
I'm going to kill you.
Oh, yes. I'm going to kill you, good.
Is that so? You can try if you like, and then we'll feed you to the pigs.
Get off my land!
This is Bolton land now, boy. Lord Bolton is the new Warden of the North. I reckon he'd like a proper lordly sword like that.
No.
I'll have that sword, boy.
Aye. You'll have it.
Well, this is not going well for me. This is going very poorly.
All right. Finish this fucking pig farmer. Pathetic. You really are a pig farmer, aren't you?
Oh. Well, hey, man. How's that throat of yours? I'd like to go for the axe if I could. I like how you guys think that help is coming. This is Game of fucking Thrones. There is no help. I'm on my own. Oh, fuck. Oh, I'm fucked. I'm fucked! Get wrecked, dude! I'm gonna stab you with your own dagger! Do it! Do it! At least the dude didn't have a crossbow. Really? I was waiting, like, dramatically to press E, and it... Oh, goddamn. Wow, this is super deadly. I was like gonna press it at the last second, and then when I pressed it, there was nothing. I need to get that sword, son. Get that sword, deliver it back to Iron Wrath, tell my uncle something about North Grove. I know my objectives as a knight. I am Sir Garrett. I ain't no punk-ass bitch. This time I'm just gonna dodge early, dog. I ain't doing none of that shit.
Mercy, please.
Nope.
I beg of you.
Close.
I have a family. They'll never survive without me. I have no quarrel with you. No, please.
You either win or you die,
Lord
bitch.
Whitefield will see you hang for this.
That's the price of the game.
That much I promise. Father?
You killed my father, Brit.
You survived. Your sister. She hid.
Here's the emblem of House Perkins right now.
I tried to stop them.
An angry cat that still thinks it's a kitten.
I'll kill the men who did this.
Yeah, I'm sure later in the game, Britt's gonna show up and be like, oh, what? This guy isn't worthy of justice because he killed some dude who was asking for mercy. No, that motherfucker killed my father. So did you. And you tried to steal my sword, dicks. I feel like Garrett Forrester right here, whatever my fucking name is, Sir Garrett, is just gonna fucking kill everyone.
It's Garrett!
Yep.
Get the castellan! Tell him his nephew survived!
Winter is coming! And then I fall over and die. I literally Garrett. Just say winter is coming.
I was too late. They were already dead.
My father.
Bring the maester! Meet us in the Great Hall! Quickly!
How is this dude castellan and his brother is a pig farmer with like four pigs?
Two Whitehill soldiers and a Bolton. They killed my family. And for what? My sister,
She was only 8 years old.
This never would have happened with the Starks in power. It's unimaginable. Unacceptable. You have my condolences.
Thank you, Maester.
The blade cut deep, but I should be able to save your leg.
Your justice was swift.
Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the Whitehills will claim it was murder. It was your family. I can't say I would have done any different than you. But the Whitehills won't see it that way.
I'd do it again if I had the chance.
If we don't respond with strength, they won't stop until they have everything.
Yeah.
These maggots ought to help prevent infection. Hold the wound open for me, would you?
Delicious. So the maggots will only eat dead flesh. They don't eat living flesh.
These are dark days, I fear. To lose the lord of the house and the eldest son through such a despicable act of treachery and betrayal. Greater houses than ours have fallen in times such as this. The late Lord Forrester was a good man. And poor Roderick. A serious man, but he would have made a good lord.
Our house will never fall.
By the gods, let's hope you're right. The future of this house is in Lord Ethan's hands now, although he is young and altogether unprepared to lead.
So basically he's Rob Stark.
Right. This might hurt a bit. Hold this for me, will you? I understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved your life.
He did.
Rather odd, though, that he chose to save you, his squire, and not his son, Roderick. Not that Roderick couldn't handle himself. He was as good with a sword as any man I've seen. It's unfortunate the Citadel doesn't train maesters in the art of warcraft.
That's not how it happened. Roderick had already fallen.
Well, I'd imagine Lord Forrester would sacrifice himself to save anyone from his house, high or low. Lady Forrester will be here any moment now. I'd like you to walk for me first, to see if you can put any weight on that leg.
I'm guessing, given that there's a walking mechanic.
Go on.
I'm gonna have to
walk. Stop now.
A lot.
It's better to let the blood circulate.
The Lord's Chair. I think this is $10 on Steam right now, Buddha.
The Ironwood Grove.
Not sure. Men have killed for that ironwood. That we work so hard on with the family's axes. On the axes of every family in Forrester lands. The North will remember Jon Snow.
This might help.
Rather cute little creatures, aren't they?
I guess.
You what, mate?
You seem to be favoring it. Always sad to see a warrior lose a leg.
I'm fine, Maester Otengrin. Look, I'll show you.
So I can't leave yet, huh? What about them axes up there? I want them axes. Right, apparently I can't get it.
Keep moving. I need to see you walk.
But Maester, these boots ain't made for walking.
Does your leg feel weak?
No. I just wanted to ask you. Who is the new lord of House Forrester?
Why, Ethan, of course. At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve whichever noble house I was assigned. Advising the late Lord Forrester was an honor. Advising Ethan, his third-born son, is challenging. There's still so much he has to learn, yet the very fate and future of this house rests in his hands.
Wait.
Which is rather frightening when you think about it.
Third son? What happened to number two? I mean, literally we went Roderick, nobody, Ethan?
Why do the White Hills hate the Foresters?
I think it's safe to say the feeling is mutual. There's been enmity between the two houses for as long as anyone can remember. I don't doubt someone killed someone, which led to more killings of someones, and then, well, here we are.
The White Hills want Forrester Ironwood.
Ah, they'd take it all if we'd let them. Especially now with the Boltons
in
power.
That's possible.
And proceed to clear-cut every last inch of it until there's nothing left. Just as they've done before.
What will happen to me now?
Excellent question. Under normal circumstances, you could join Sir Roiland and his men. Although, given the circumstances of your... circumstances, it becomes a bit tricky, doesn't it? I suppose it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
Lord Forrester promoted me. At the Twins, I'm no longer a squire, if that matters.
It might, I suppose. But I'll defer to Lord Ethan on this.
Can I see Ethan? Is he here?
He is, but I'm afraid he's indisposed at the moment. He prefers not to be disturbed while practicing his lute.
Can I go now?
I believe your leg will be fine. Only time will tell, but... Lady Forrester.
Welcome home, Garrett. We're all relieved to know you survived.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garrett, I heard what happened.
That's a familiar name.
Is it true? Your family... I'm so sorry.
Mato.
Man, there's some weird watercolor effects going on all over the place.
Off to bed now. Hurry on.
Oh, with her? Together? Oh, no, you... Of course. My apologies.
Garrett was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end. Even when all was lost.
Yeah, he totally tried to handle it.
I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know. Whatever you can recall.
He saved my life, my lady.
Yet not Roderick's.
You were with Roderick, no? I'm sure it was chaos and confusion. But if you can remember anything, I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
He fought valiantly, my lady.
Of course he did. He was House Forrester's best.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us, especially the children. But I was told you were the last to see my husband alive.
Yes, my lady.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask, was there anything he said?
Any last words before he passed, if you can remember? It would mean so much to the family.
He said he loved you.
That's very kind of you to say. You have the Forrester's sword.
Ethan should have it, now that he is Lord.
Lord Forrester asked me to return it to the house. He said this is where it belongs. With his family.
Thank you, Garrett.
Of course, my lady.
It demands a response.
It's too dangerous, especially now.
Now is the time to prove our strength.
I'll be sure it's given to Ethan.
An age of aggression, perhaps?
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family.
I share your outrage, Sir Roiland. I do. But now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming to see us bend the knee.
The hell with Ramsay Snow, the bastard.
Garrett, you understand what this means. You killed a Bolton, and Ramsay Snow will want his retribution.
We're the ones who should be demanding retribution. This happened on Forrester land.
They killed my family.
And they'll pay for what they've done. That much I promise. But now is not the time for vengeance.
It's always time for vengeance.
We have to be smart. Ramsay Snow will be here within the week.
Good, we can kill him.
And what would you have us do? Nothing.
I would have us use our heads while they're still attached to our shoulders.
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these walls. Maybe you can talk some sense into your uncle.
Garrett's suffered enough already. You ask too much of the boy.
He deserves to be heard.
My uncle's right. We need to be smart.
Smart. Eddard Stark was smart. And look where that got him. So, what's to be done?
You might be asking, ultimately, if I want vengeance, why did I side with my uncle?
He's just a boy.
This is Game of Thrones.
The
only people you can trust is your own fucking family.
He's the lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and
swear
fealty.
Trust your fucking family.
But now, this... I'll accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you.
The boy was just defending himself.
I'm not faulting him for what he did.
I'd have done the same, as any man would.
It wasn't murder. It was justice.
Not in their eyes. It's just the excuse Ramsay Snow would need to put us to the torch and kill us all.
I'd like to see them try.
I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take, which is why you cannot stay.
Cannot stay? Duncan.
But where would I go?
The one place beyond the reach of even House Bolton.
The wall.
You're sending him to the wall? The boy's done nothing wrong.
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's the only solution. Especially now, when the house is so vulnerable.
Uncle, my place is here. Who would defend the house? You said we need men who can fight.
There'd be nothing we could do to protect you. To stay would bring destruction upon us all. I know that's not what you want. I know it's difficult to understand. But you must think of the house.
I'll do what's asked of me.
I know it doesn't seem fair, but it is what's best.
That settles it then.
You can have my horse. And I'll see you have plenty of food, but we haven't much time. The White Hills will come looking for you.
How different is the game if you choose not to murk that guy? You somehow still end up getting sent
Word
to the
up
wall?
To me. I'd gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart if given a chance. I would. And God's willing, someday I will. But for now, I have House Forrester to consider first.
I have a message to tell you,
Uncle. I know you want to stay.
If you'd shut the fuck up
Lord
for 5 seconds.
Lord Forrester would be proud that you're putting the interests of the house ahead of your own. Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war. His own great-uncle was a ranger with the Night's Watch.
He promoted me. Met the twins. We were to ride in the van to Casterly Rock and I at Roderick's side, but...
It was well-deserved, Garrett. You worked hard and served your lord with honor.
I've been waiting for the right moment to tell you.
What?
Lord Forrester asked me to give you a message. He said, "The North Grove can never be lost."
Sorry, you caught me by surprise. It's not often discussed, if ever.
He said tell only you.
For good reason. Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way. I assume you kept your word. You haven't told anyone else, have you? This is important, Garrett. I need to know the truth.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you. From this day forward, this will be our secret. But soon, I may need your help.
But...
I can't say anything more just yet. Just know the North Grove may very well be vital to the future of this house. But don't breathe a word of it to anyone at the wall. Become a ranger if you can. It will help.
I become a steward.
Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Remember, you represent House Forrester. Your actions at the wall will reflect the honor and dignity of the house.
I'll serve with honor.
I know you will.
Garrett, wait!
What's up, Talia? I don't suppose you want to get locked in a cryogenic vault for a couple hundred years.
Be safe.
Look at this smug dude. Literally just smugging.
I couldn't find him. Could you? He hides too well. And if he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
You found me! Well done, Ryan. Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
It's all right.
You're
the winner.
I was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
And this dude instantly dies.
And Asher. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and...
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
That's a terrible promise.
I don't want Gerd to die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the wall. I'll miss Gerd. He was nice.
He'll be fine. Gerd is smart.
No one will tell me what Gerd did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you. But I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland, for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
Sir Roiland is correct.
And he calls you a milksop.
Also true.
Sir Roiland forgets himself.
He doesn't know me or what I'm capable of.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know. But I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword. Like a man. He taught Roderick and Asher, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asher. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then... Well, then everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training, and he never smiled anymore. And Asher just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are. I know a lord has many responsibilities.
I may have to change.
I'd rather have my brother than a lord.
I'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
I know that's what you want, but I have to protect all the Foresters.
You can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
No, Ryan.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once.
That's not how it works.
Well, that's how it should work. You are the Lord.
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
I'm on my way. I'm about to dispense some justice. Justice.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced, and certainly unexpected.
Stab him in the neck, then.
He's demanding justice.
Let's have him killed.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan. Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
Of course not.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
If I were Lord, I would command Ethan to stay with his family.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well, then.
I'm not going to play some little shit who plays a lute and stays out in the fucking forest with his fam. I am Roderick. I am the North.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
The business with Garrod. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrod is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction. Out there, you were decisive and firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
I can handle Lord Whitehill.
Well said, my lord.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got 5 times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men roll over.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house, but to his family it's still a loss. My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life. The Forresters finally get their due.
I may be young, but I'm not so easily fooled. You're trying to rile me, but it won't work.
Young? You are that boy. Too young to know when you're in over your head. And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected as much.
Calm yourself, old man.
You little fuck! That's how you talk to a lord? You Foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roose Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
We all serve House Bolton now.
I'm not finished! Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Who the fuck is this clan?
Your man, the Squire. We were minding our own business, keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said. When your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
No reason? You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name.
We lost people too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. Soldiers worth 100 of their type. Where's the fucking coward who killed my men? I know he's here. What have you done with him?
He was sent to the wall.
Who the fuck sent him to the wall? Answer me! Who's the one who did it?
I did.
What? That was my justice to deliver, boy. And you denied me of it. I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton. What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Get wrecked, son.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all.
Didn't you just say you wanted to drive a dagger through the heart of her husband?
This is not over!
It's over when my son says it is.
This is over, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own, that the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
You're a craven, Lord Whitehill.
Get wrecked, son. Well, Duncan's probably not going to like that, but I'm guessing Sir Roland will.
I was wrong about your son, my lady. He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee.
Good, we'll kill him too.
Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once. Your sister can help us. Although just a handmaiden, she has Marjorie Tyrell's favor. And Lady Marjorie's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay.
Marjorie Tyrell.
If it's presented to her as it should be.
No, cat, go away. A box of ironwood.
Asher sent me this coin to remember him. What a strange place, Essos.
So, what that implies is that Asher, who I'm guessing is the second son, is still alive, and therefore, if he comes back and inherit, probably a plot point for later.
It was very kind of Lady Marjorie to give this to me. It once belonged to Lady Elena.
Lady Elena. That's basically my grandmother right there.
Ethan made this for me.
You seem very sad. Super sad.
Father. Much excitement here in King's Landing for the coming wedding. Lady Marjorie has proven to be quite popular throughout the city. I do wish you and Mother could come, although I know it would be impossible under the circumstances. I miss all of you, and I look forward to the day you can. Wonders Made by Man, by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick. I hope to see them all someday.
No, they're mostly dead.
King's Landing.
What a shithole.
I wonder if it's sunny at Ironwrath today.
It's not. It's raining blood.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
Nothing in the foreground, huh? Okay.
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine. Come in.
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you all right? If you don't mind my asking. You seem rather upset.
I'm fine, thank you.
Of course, m'lady.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady. You work for Lady Marjorie? I may be wrong, but it seems like you do.
I'm her handmaiden.
That's what I thought. I've seen you with her before. You seem like good friends. I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Oh, shit.
Cersei.
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but it was definitely an argument.
What did they say?
I couldn't make out much, but I know they were talking about the Starks and... and House Forrester.
House Forrester?
I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. But I thought you ought to know. Most people don't tend to notice a call boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, m'lady.
Thank you, call boy. Into my room was a valuable addition.
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss.
I can't tell if that's actually Natalie Dorner or not.
From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family.
But...
I feel your pain as if it were my own.
But...
what you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
I need your help, my lady.
Of course. And I will help you in any way I can.
But...
but there's another matter we must attend to first. You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor. She was very pleased with herself. Her face was full of mirth as she said it.
I'm not a traitor.
Of course not. It's only an excuse to torment you and, by extension, me. She demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort, for what I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important.
I have no idea how to handle this situation.
I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
What do I say?
Find a way to appease her.
Appease her, huh?
Humor her. Tell her what she wants to hear.
So in the north, when I'm lord, I take the iron fist. When I'm here, I must be the willow and bend to the desires of everyone necessary. Sure.
You'll be fine.
I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Got it.
Good luck.
Thank you, random person in a green dress. All right, blue dress. I'm going in. She's probably going to be in either red or gold. Unsurprisingly, she's in both red and gold. Oh shit, it's Tyrion! Everyone lose your shit in chat! It's Tyrion! He's going to say something witty. He's going to say something witty. This is a thing. That's going to happen. Lose your shit. What's up, Kingsguard? I think, right? You got the white cloak? I guess maybe you're just a white cloak. That's some fancy looking armor, though.
Ah, Lady Marjorie. Aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion. Your Grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Queen Regent.
Your Grace. The girl knows her courtesies. Impressive. You may rise. House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is. The girl can speak for her house.
Joffrey is the one true king, Your Grace.
Hmm. And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark, a house of traitors.
Yes, Your Grace. They are traitors.
The Starks were your liege lord, yet you name them traitors so easily. I take it this is the kind of loyalty the king can expect from you. If you have any loyalty at all.
Ah, should have said they were our wardens, I guess.
Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Sure.
He is the Warden of the North, Your Grace.
He is. And I the Queen Regent and Tyrion the Master of Coin.
You're just saying things now. You're
the
literally just
saying
words.
The girl has a remarkable talent for answering questions while in fact saying nothing at all.
Old allegiances are not easily abandoned, but now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Yes, Your Grace.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you?
Oh, shit.
Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
Yes, Your Grace. I would do anything.
Anything?
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
She was just following her heart, Your Grace.
And the very same heart so quickly led her to my son.
Oh, if there's a point to this, I hope you find
it. Damn it!
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious
I'm not doing well here, guys.
Looking to reinvent themselves.
I'm trying my best.
Pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Marjorie. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she would...
Let the girl answer the question. Go on.
I would be true to the king, your grace.
Well said. I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
My sense is this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants. Which is not very encouraging. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
Oh, shit. Well, that was a situation that was handled poorly. So here's Marjorie like, say anything in order to get the queen on your side. And then the queen's like, oh, well, I guess you said anything. Surprise,
but I met your father once at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man.
Which is why it's no surprise he's dead.
My condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
That certainly took courage. To so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Marjorie was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining. No doubt Lady Marjorie will forgive
me. I didn't click on anything. God damn it.
My sister and I have our differences.
Shit.
She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard. Not her.
You can help my family.
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Marjorie might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that?
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion. Please.
You are a brave girl, aren't you? I'll consider it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. 3 beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
I hope we meet again.
Nothing would make Cersei happier. Until then, be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
That's right. Fuck Marjorie and fuck the Queen. I'm going to save my family doing whatever it takes. Gotta be nice to Cersei? Fine. Nice to Marjorie? Fine. Nice to Tyrion? Yeah, fuck everyone else. Hey, what's up, unnamed handmaiden?
Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. It's more than a little intimidating.
It didn't go very well.
I'm sorry. Cersei is known for being rather difficult. But at least it's over now. Lady Marjorie has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back, here with the 4th cousins and the 9th-born sons. Ah, Sir Jaime, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah!
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour. Which I doubt is Dornish for wife.
You'll get us in trouble.
We're just having some fun. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king? I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen?
Nope.
He does have a certain look about him. And he's always treated Lady Marjorie well.
I'd be willing to marry, but not Joffrey.
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden. Let's see, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match! Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well?
I told her to stop, my lady.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira.
I, however, was not.
King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes.
It said that she was displeased
by
the display. There's
always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Dread, I am a tattletale. Cottontailed.
Do you agree?
People are not always so easy to please. If you showed Cersei your true heart, she would stab it with a fork.
You learn very quickly.
Nope.
Your words to Cersei were brave. But I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important. I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Syrah. There are no secrets between us.
Syrah dislikes me and is clearly...
It's about my family.
...going to ruin my life.
I trust her. Go on. Ask.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise, but my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire?
You can't, my lady. King Joffrey won't like it. Just think how he turned on Lady Sansa.
Please, Lady Marjorie, I beg of you. I fear for my family's safety.
I don't know, Mira. If Cersei were to find out...
Don't let the Queen bully you. You have power over him, Lady Marjorie, as no one else does. Not even his mother.
That power is called sex,
Ramsay
by the
Snow
way.
Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady.
I owe you a lot.
I will send a raven to my family at once.
All right, Sarah, what scheme are you up to? As I'm sure you're going to destroy everything through your pointless scheming. By the way, Cottontailed, sweet pick, by the way, of Gamer Siren. Is that a tiny cat over her shoulder?
Oh,
that someone being tortured to death? There goes my horse.
Seven hells.
Seven hells.
I am loyal to your father. I am loyal to have both, please. No.
This is Ramsay Snow.
No, stop, no, please, no, stop, no!
Let's play a little game, shall we? Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat? Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy, what with all that bloody noise.
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets, but the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father is the Warden of the North.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
Shh! Listen. There. Hear that? I know I heard something.
Come on, horse. I need to save my life.
Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
That's Sir Garrett, everybody. Sir Garrett. Greatest knight in the land. Pissing his britches, hiding behind a tree. Sir Garrett. Doesn't even have a horse. What kind of bloody knight doesn't have a horse? Hey, bud, you still alive over there?
Bloody hell!
Back to Lord Ethan, then.
Lord Ethan! As I was saying, you are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership.
Only because they don't know I'm made of iron.
But 300 generations of Forester Lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house. And your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise, and courageous in battle.
And what will they call me?
That is for you to define as the new lord. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others, the Lord Sentinel. Forester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move!
That's my new Sentinel right there.
We need his judgment.
I've done nothing wrong! I was only trying to survive!
Lord Ethan. Maester.
You spoke of judgment, Sir Roiland. What judgment is that?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed! We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
Is what Sir Roiland said true?
Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks true.
He's right. I've a family to feed. And not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Mercy. Go.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter. Most of us won't even live to see it.
Then you admit to the crime, in front of all gathered here.
I am only what this house made me. You cannot expect a man to live on loyalty alone.
You'll address him as Lord.
Well, I can't be responsible for what happened before now.
Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it is.
Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit it.
He's a thief!
We can send him to the war.
Leave the man alone! Show him mercy, my lord! He stole from us!
He deserved
to. Make him pay for what he's done! Give us justice!
Fuck him!
I will decide.
Send him to the war!
Leave the poor man!
Take his fingers!
He's a thief! If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. Will be an injustice, my lord. Please, my lord. My family depends on me.
I can't show you mercy, buddy.
I sentence you to the wall, where you will join the Night's Watch.
No, please, my lord! My family, without me, they'll die!
Well, at least there wasn't a riot.
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due.
Not just yourself, of course. It can weigh on any lord.
Maester, what do you think?
Me?
Yes. Did I do what's right?
The wall seems like a fitting place for a thief. I only hope he doesn't find Garrett there and take his anger out on the poor squire.
You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side. Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance. Possessing wisdom.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
I choose my sister Talia.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here, the bracer of the sentinel, the badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your sentinel will wear this for all to see.
Thank you for your counsel, Maester.
It is my duty. Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Hey, what's up, Riga? Welcome to the stream. Things have been going pretty poorly so far. Pretty poorly. Feel like I'm making all the wrong choices and none of the right ones. I've already pissed off Queen Cersei, Lady Marjorie Tyrell. Bruce Bolton, I seem to have upset his friends for killing a White Hill or a Bolton or something. I totally murked some dude.
Come on, you dogs! You'll not be fighting!
Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure.
Eric said people were going to starve. Why can't we feed them?
The war has taken its toll. Even our own stores for the house are dwindling.
We're doomed.
We couldn't withstand the siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight. But there are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before in desperate times. The last long winter, my family had to give all our pigs to the house.
No, there must be something else we can do.
Well, I hope we find it soon. We won't have much room to maneuver if we don't have the option of holding fast. I can speak to the huntsmen and trappers. Perhaps they can do more. My lord.
That sounded like a pretty unsatisfactory answer.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight.
Actually, I wanted to ask, why did you send Garrett away?
I did it for your own protection, my lord. Garrett had to go. By sending him away myself, I thought it would keep you blameless in the eyes of the White Hills. I only hope to give you an advantage.
That's a clever strategy.
I do hope that's a good thing, my lord.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
I don't like that you're doing things without speaking to me first. Kind of bypassing justice there.
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do, showing mercy to a man who admits his guilt. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow. At first light.
But where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him, to help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree.
I do not agree.
I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
I must be firm. I'm not a boy anymore, and there is too much at stake.
The Lord's work can harden a man. It's true.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice, and I'd trust him.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you. Mother told me, Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man. I know you told me you'd have to change, but I suppose I hadn't believed you would.
It was
I can't
mercy.
Afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrett being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know. And that wasn't your fault.
Well, I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan, please. Tell me.
What do you suggest I do?
You must be strong, decisive. You are the lord of this house. Remember, you're just as capable as Asher or Roderick ever were. I know it. I only wish you did too.
You have always given me good advice. Thank you.
Don't send for fucking Asher. Are you kidding me? Asher, literally probably the dude that's going to take my throne from me. Is there anyone else to talk to around here? I'll tell you what, chat. I'm going to let you give me some advice here, but I'm really feeling that... I'm really feeling Sir Roland. Duncan doesn't consult me for shit. He does shit behind my back. He's kind of a dick. I mean, yeah, he offers sage and wise advice, but I need a warrior up front.
Do it like you mean it.
Careful. Keep you let me know how you feel. You won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call mine Two Brothers. I carve this to give me strength. And this, so I remember. I mean, I could never forget. But, oh, you know, don't you?
You honor Roderick with this. He was a strong one.
He was. Yeah. Someday, I'll have a real one. But not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
You'll have a good sword. I'm sure of it.
I watched you today. I saw what you did to that man. Was he our enemy? A bad man? Everyone keeps talking about them. Enemies.
Rules mean nothing if we don't enforce them. It doesn't matter if he's good or bad. You can't steal. That's a rule.
Well, I say he was bad. Bad men killed Father and Roderick. They need someone to hurt them back. Even worse. I want a real sword. No one's afraid of wood. I'll find the men who took Roderick someday, and I'll make sure I have a real sword when I do.
That's a little concerning. Alright, well, time to go over to my boy.
Sword up! Swing left! Sorry! Wrong! I didn't know
Sir
dogs
Roiland,
could hold swords!
Word?
Of course, my lord.
I have many decisions to make, and I wanted your advice. What's the state of our defences? Are these men ready for what's coming?
This lot, ready? No, but they will be. We post anyone who can hold a spear along the parapet, up where they won't get much scrutiny, and put our meanest, nastiest-looking brutes front and centre. That'll show Ramsay we're a force in our own right. You've got to project power, especially when you're weakened.
Thank you, Sir
Roiland.
That's
some sons you shit.
I'll let you get back to training these men.
Thank you, my lord. And I'll be sure to watch out for more deserters. After today, I suspect there'll be more to come.
Really? They're going to get sent to the wall if they desert.
Yes, my lord.
I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to me. I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins or wield the sword in equal measure. I'm the man you need. And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garrett to the wall. He undermined your authority and made you look weak to the White Hills.
I agree with
I
that.
I would never do that to you. And if you pardon me saying so, I think your father would be proud.
Your words are wise, Sir Roiland.
Thank you, my lord.
I will consider them as I make my choice.
So, when will you declare your decision, my lord?
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
I could give it to you now, but I'm not going to, because everyone keeps talking about that small council meeting. So let's start that meeting, huh?
Swords up! You can lift them, yeah?
Alright, Maester.
Maester?
So, tell me what you want.
Yes,
what you
really, really want. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
I am.
What is it you're doing over here?
Admiring the ironwood, my lord. I studied it at the Citadel. The wood may be black, but I see gold. An entire forest of gold.
What do you mean?
It is our greatest asset, my lord. Why not give some of our ironwood to House Bolton and have them leave us be? We could ransom ourselves. You can hardly put a price on your own life, or the lives of those you love.
A sensible plan, Maester. It may come to that.
I'm glad to hear your mind is open to possibility.
Just not the Northern Grove.
My lord, are you now ready to name your sentinel?
Yes, Maester. I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
Very well. It's me, Emperor Palpatine. I'm Maester of this house.
For some reason, I don't trust this guy very much.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you.
It's my mom.
Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
Let him be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision.
Give Bracer to your mom. Nope, that's
Sir Roiland de Gore, you will be my sentinel.
Gods be praised. You've done well, Lord Ethan. You won't regret this.
A poor choice, my lord. Forgive me for saying so, but it's true.
Now, sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
My scouts say he's a day's ride away. We've no time to waste. He'll arrive before any of our allies could be here.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword.
That's bloody suicide. You'd gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls.
Quiet, Tuttle. You're not the Sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the small council, is it not?
Let Duncan speak. I'd like to hear what he has to say. Duncan?
I'm sorry, Lord Ethan. You have chosen your sentinel. You should hear from him first.
The Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand. Put every man who can hold a spear or crossbow on the wall and make the bastard fill his boots with piss.
He would see it for the empty gesture that it is, and have us flayed. We must take a measured approach, my lord.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf, but we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
Mother, what do you recommend we do?
We must give him whatever he wants and be done with it. It's too dangerous to do otherwise.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough!
Wow, holy shit. This is tough. Fighting is not an option here. It's either going to be diplomacy or bargaining.
Although Sir Roiland may object, I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall, and meet him face to face, lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Lord Ethan?
God damn it. Those are both equally good choices. I feel like I have to trust in Roiland, though, for this part.
Yep, I will meet him in the Great Hall.
Appeasement!
It's careless. Can't you see Tuttle is steering you wrong? You'll lead us into ruin!
I've faithfully served this house for far too long to sit here and listen to this. You're likely to get us all killed.
Sit down at once.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall, and we will not offer our ironwood.
No matter what, I will stand beside you, my lord, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
My lord, you have named your sentinel, but you still seem conflicted. And no matter what, you can't be indecisive. Not if you want to help this house. Forgive me.
There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister. And we need all the help we can get.
But won't he be lord if he returns? Do you want him to take my place?
Of course not. He has no interest in such things. And that's not what I want either. Asher is volatile. But that is his strength, too. Do you remember the Miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the Miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious. But you were in danger, and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities. But you do not have that anger inside you. It's something we could use.
I'm not like that, but I don't need to be, do I?
No, but you need someone who is standing beside you.
Why, I have Sir Roiland.
I'm trying to do what's best for this family, what this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Fine. Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
I don't think one man's going to change the fate of the battle against the Boltons.
I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone.
So we can afford to lose Malcolm, forester. I guess.
Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
I'm no thief. I'm not just gonna pick up her shit.
Marjorie? Oh. Lady Marjorie is still with the king. I thought you'd want to know. Thank you. Mira, look. The other day when you asked Lady Marjorie for help, I only spoke out of fear for her. I want to help you if there's anything I can do. Your poor family. I can't imagine how you must feel.
You're sweet to offer, Sarah. Thank you.
Lady Marjorie is always saying how important friends and allies are in King's Landing. Just know, I will be here for you if you ever...
Yes? You can't help my family.
I'll leave you to talk.
The look of someone who's about to give me some bad news.
Are you all right, my lady?
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family. I'll need this mended.
Gods.
He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again. Nothing I said could cheer him. He wouldn't even speak to me when I left him.
What can I do to make this better, my lady?
There's nothing you can do, Mira.
Understand, it was my mother's plan, not mine. I just hope you can find some way to forgive me.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira. Not in King's Landing.
I'm sorry, my lady.
Soon I will be queen, and maybe then I'll be in a better position to help you. But for now, we must both be cautious.
I must send a raven. I have to warn my family, if you'll excuse me, my lady.
And then I run into Tyrion.
M'lady.
Ah, cold boy.
Begging your pardon, m'lady. I hope I didn't frighten you.
I'm glad to see you.
Thank you, m'lady. I hope you saw. I was right before. About Lady Marjorie and Queen Cersei. I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like. And your family. If you're willing to trust me, I hear all sorts of things. Things that could be useful for you.
How can you help me? My problems can't be solved by what you might overhear.
Which is why you must trust me, m'lady. You need allies. Hopefully I've proven I can be useful to you.
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who... People who'd be willing to help you.
I don't know how to feel about Cold Boy. He seems unusually willing to help, given that I know nothing about him.
Where the bloody hell is Duncan? He should be here. Now fuck him if he's angry. We'll do without him.
and without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us, but I'm confident we've enough strength of our own. Your men are ready to act if needed.
Our plan is a good one. It will work so long as everyone does their part.
Ramsay?
Isn't this a lovely pile of timber? Not the place I'd want to be if there was a fire.
Ironwood is near impervious to flame, my lord.
Is it?
May I introduce Lord Ramsay of House Bolton, son of Roos Bolton? Although a bastard, Lord Ramsay has the full authority of
Thank
the
you,
Warden of the...
That's enough. Who is this little boy? Is he lost?
May I offer you bread and salt, Lord Ramsay?
I loathe bread and salt. Aren't you the little lord? Lord Whitehall told me you were young, but this... Look at you.
A token for the new Warden of the North.
Let me guess. Forrester Ironwood.
Carved by our most skilled craftsmen.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much. Don't know what's so special about it.
Your father will appreciate it, I hope. Our ironwood is highly sought after.
My father is not so easily impressed. Not bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn...
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently.
Okay, score one for us.
Look at that. More foresters.
Lord Ramsay...
Come out where I can see you.
Now that got creepy.
Force him to focus on the business at hand.
Lord Ramsay, I understand you've come here for assurance of our fealty.
Fuck fealty. We came here for justice.
We'll get to your justice. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father. Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it? Here's the thing. I don't care about your loyalty. The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships... Shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the king. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
No, Lord Ramsay.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust a forester. They murdered our men.
It was a forester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead, one Bolton. Yet your man lived.
Lord Whitehill is a liar. That's not how it happened.
Lad? A liar? He's a Whitehill. Then you welcomed me into your hall like a proper lord, hoping I wouldn't linger outside long enough to notice your pathetic little army. That sort of insolence from one of our... loyal bannermen will not do. So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone. The Whitehills will be taking control of your ironwood from this day forward.
What?
What? The ironwood? But...
The Whitehills are nothing more than up-jump thieves!
You can't do that!
Why not? You know something the Whitehills don't? We are talking about trees. You grow them, you cut them down. It can't be that difficult.
We have loyal craftsmen who make the finest weapons. The Whitehills have no such craftsmen. Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years, or the next 50 generations?
The little lord does have a point.
Yeah, get fucking wrecked,
we'll
bud.
We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your ironwood, and we'll see who fares better.
No. Nope.
But my lord...
Half of something is better than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironwrath, that we cannot abide. Ethan.
They'll help maintain the king's peace. And make sure there's no more trouble.
This will cause more trouble, not less.
Not for me. You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
Griff will lead the garrison.
The Seven Hells he will.
Lads, do make this visit worthwhile.
Please, Sir Roiland, don't.
Look at this, little forester. You're not frightened, are you?
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Ethan's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Ah, twins. Well, like the Queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the Queen and her brother. I never had a sister. Always wanted one.
We have more to discuss, Lord Snow.
I have an idea. You'll come with me. You can be my highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
She's quite pretty, your sister. We'd get along well.
You've gone too far, Lord Ramsay. I demand you let her go.
I suppose you can stay. Aren't you the brave lord?
Oh, Ethan!
That's bad.
What have you done?
But I don't want the brave lord. Far too much trouble.
Ethan!
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 My lord!
Oh, no!
Where are my fucking men?
My son.
I think we've come to an understanding.
Ethan!
I certainly feel better about all this.
Ethan! Oh, come on.
However, the foresters need to keep their end of the bargain.
Stop!
Brian!
Take the boy as your ward.
No!
Kill him if they give you any trouble.
Brian!
Lovely meeting all of you. We'll have to do it again sometime.
Somebody help him!
Fetch the maester, quickly!
You brought this on yourself.
Mama!
Please. Stop!
Don't let him take me!
Wow.
You will not take
Stop
him!
Stop them! Please! Brian, please!
No!
No!
Brian!
Do something!
Ethan?
My son.
Okay, so diplomacy may have been a mistake. Your story has begun. Next time on Game of Thrones...
Ethan sacrificed himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalties. Those who will not stop
John
until Ethan
Steel.
Is available. Until Ryan is home again, our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?
Next time. Leave that motherfucker Bowen behind. Wow, I made a lot of choices that people did not choose. Wow, most people did not pick Roiland Ascent. Oh, okay. All right. That's all a thing.
That's all things that happened. Alright. We're now 2 hours in, guys. We're gonna take a 5-minute break. Go get your water or drink, go to the bathroom, get some food. We'll be back for part two. Ba 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 ba